أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإن طائفتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا فأصلحوا بينهما فإن بغت إحداهما على الأخرى فقاتلوا التي تبغي حتى تفيء إلى أمر الله فإن فاءت فأصلحوا بينهما بالعدل وأقسطوا إن الله يحب المقسطين إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون
رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم ثبتنا عند الموت بلا إله إلا الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته إن شاء الله تعالى we're covering a couple of آيات from سورة الحجرات today on the subject of reconciliation between Muslims. It is not an alien phenomenon to the Muslim community that fights occur between Muslims and rifts and disunity occurs between Muslims. And Muslims living in the West are no exception. We tend to point the finger at the Muslims living in the rest of the world and say, look, they're divided by sectarianism and they're fighting each other and they hate each other and all of this stuff. And yet the same drama happens in our masajid. So we're no exception. Now Allah Azza wa Jal gives us beautiful counsel in these ayat about how to avoid and how to reconcile. If it occurs, how to reconcile these situations. And the advice is, you know, appropriately, the best word I have for it, it's divine advice. It's such profound advice that if it's taken really, there's no room left for any fitna to remain among Muslims. Also, these are ayat that expose the miracle of the Qur'an and Allah's choice of words. That the choice of the words in these ayat and Allah constructs the sentences is so perfect and so incredible that you're left with no choice but to say this can only be the word of Allah. So we'll explore both angles of this ayah, inshaAllah ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hujarat, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلُوا. If two groups, طَائِفَتَان, from out of the believers, fight one another, اقْتَتَلُوا. Now those of you that know a little bit of Arabic, I'm going to share something with you, and those of you that don't, I want you to feel bad about it, so that you have to learn Arabic. There was an Orientalist, a French Orientalist, that actually wrote about this ayah and said that this is grammatically incorrect. That the Arabic in this ayah is grammatically incorrect. And the reason he said this, again for those of you who know a little bit of Arabic, this is a jumla ismiya. Even though it's jumla shartiya with an in the beginning, it's jumla ismiya. And in jumla ismiya you have mubtada and then you have what? Those of you who know. You have khabar, okay. Now, in jumla ismiya, if you have an ism, if you have a, in simple words, if you have a noun, the verb or the fi'il you have to use, it has to be consistent in terms of gender and in terms of number, both. Allah says, ta'ifatani. And to make it as simple as possible, ta'ifatani means two groups. Two groups. And since ta'ifatani is feminine, the Arabic word should have been iqtatalata. The two groups fight one another, the word would be iqtatalata. But Allah doesn't say two groups fight, He says iqtatalu, they fight. More than two. How many groups does Allah mention? Two. When it comes to the fighting one another, He doesn't mention two groups fighting, He mentions many people fighting one another. Right? So the grammarian, the French grammarian says, look, the first part of the ayah is talking about two, fa'ifatani. And when it came to the fighting part, does He mention two or more than two? He mentions more than two. And then when He's done talking about that, He says, فَأَصْلِحُ not بَيْنَهُمْ, but He says, بَيْنَهُمَا. Between both of them, He comes back to two. So the ayah starts with two groups, the ayah, that statement ends with two groups. But in the middle, there's more than two. How come? So He calls this a grammatical mistake. But look at the beauty of this ayah. Let's look at the brief meaning. Who's fighting? If Allah says, if two groups fight, but two groups of whom? Of the believers. Before the fighting occurs, there's one group of Muslims and there's the other group of Muslims. They're on opposite sides of the battlefield. So you can tell this is group A and this is group B. But what's the flag on either side? What does it say? It says La ilaha illallah. When they take a break from the fighting, what do? Both sides. They pray. The same way or different ways? The same way.
When they're running towards the enemy, what are they screaming? Takbir. Right? Before the fighting began, it's clearly two groups. Once the unfortunate fighting begins, once it begins, does it look like two groups anymore? Because they're the same group. It's really Muslims, mu'mineen even, Allah says. So it's one big tragedy of individuals fighting one another, one ummah and infighting within it. So it's not iqtatalata, it is iqtatalu, the plural. And then when the fighting stops and you have to make reconciliation between the groups, then you have to separate the groups. So you know this party had this agenda and that party had that agenda. So they're back to two again. So Allah says, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا, between both of them. But look at another thing here. You know, when Muslims fight one another, one group says, we are the true believers and the other people are munafiq. That's why we're fighting them. We are on Islam and they are all on fisq. They're corrupt. They're not true believers. That's why we're fighting them. Isn't that true? And you know what? Both sides are saying the same thing. This side of the Muslims is saying, we're the mu'mineen. The other side is saying, we're the mu'mineen. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. If two groups from who? From the mu'mineen. So what has Allah done, subhanahu wa ta'ala? He has given us the injunction to give both sides the benefit of the doubt. You can't say these are the right ones and these are the wrong ones. Not yet. For now, they are all considered mu'mineen. If they fight one another. And then, فَأَصْلِحُوا. Then you have to do something. You have to cause reconciliation. You have to make reconciliation. So you have to make the fighting stop and make peace between them. Now the person who makes peace between them is also a Muslim. A kafir is not going to come and make peace between Muslims. Who's going to make the peace? A Muslim. So if a Muslim comes and he feels that one side is true believers, and the other side, they're kind of, you know, not that Muslim. When he makes reconciliation, is he going to be biased? Absolutely. Unless he is convinced that on both sides there is what? True believers. Mu'mineen on both sides. Then he can be fair. If he doesn't think that way, then he cannot be fair. So Allah says, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلُوا فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا. And now you make reconciliation between them. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَإِن بَغَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَا عَلَى الْأُخْرَى. After you bring the two parties together and you say, what is your problem? And you say, what is your problem? Okay, we have this evidence that this happened and this happened and your group did this and your group did this. And you document everything and all the proofs are laid out. And after that, negotiations are done, compromises are made, and there's some resolution. Okay, let the fighting stop. We'll compromise 2 points. You compromise 2 points. Let's shake hands on it. It's done. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا. After you do the reconciliation, sometimes what happens is one party leaves the meeting or the convention where the peace was made, the resolution was passed, they leave that gathering and they say, you know what? I don't know. I think we were dealt a short hand. We need to seek justice still. This is no peace. They didn't open their mouth in the meeting. When did they open their mouth? After the meeting. After the meeting. And so after the meeting, they raise the fitna again, and they start the fighting one more time. One of these two groups. So Allah says, فَإِن بَغَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَا عَلَى الْأُخْرَى. If one of them rebels against the other, this is now called rebellion. Rebellion against what? The resolution, the islah that was made. So Allah says, فَقَاتِلُوا الَّذِي تَبْغِي. Then all of you, the reconciler, the one who was making peace between them, was neutral or one-sided? He was neutral. And the side that didn't violate the treaty, now they become two parties against one party. Now you have to fight that third party that violated the treaty. You know, a lot of times when there's conflict between two Muslims, or two Muslim groups, or two, you know, in masajid there's drama all the time, not this one, inshallah, but masajid all over the country, I've seen plenty of drama, right? And what happens is you have two groups of Muslims, and they make peace between them. And they shake hands and their hugs and all of this stuff. And they leave this meeting and one of them picks up the fire and lights it again. And then everybody says, you know what, let's just leave them alone. We shouldn't, don't make the situation any worse. The people say, don't make the situation any worse. So yes, they're being bad, but you know what, we can't do anything about it. If we say anything, it'll make the matters worse. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, if one of them rebels, if one of them violates the treaty that was openly made, then everybody else has to get together and get on their case. So it's not between group A and group B anymore. It's against group A versus all the Muslims, whether they're from group B or not, because they violated a treaty. You understand? If you don't do this, the fitna will remain. If you do this, the fitna will be crushed. But now look at the words. فَقَاتِلُ الَّتِي تَبْغِي حَتَّى تَفِيئَ إِلَىٰ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ تَفِيئَ. You know, fa'a in Arabic is to return. And there are many words in Arabic for returning. There's ba'a, there's raja'a, there's hada. There's plenty of words in Arabic for returning. And every one of them have their own shade. If you were doing well, like you got healthy, you used to be sick and you became healthy. And you went back to being sick again, the word used is ba'a. Meaning you go from a bad state and you return to a, or you go from a good state and you return to a bad state. But when you go from a worse state and you become better, you return to a better situation, the word is not ba'a, it is fa'a. And look, Allah says, حَتَّى تَفِيئَ, until they return. But what version of returning is used? The version of returning that implies, if they come back to the peace treaty, then that is what is better for them. They're thinking that they're fighting because the fighting is better for them. And Allah is telling them, just by using the word tafi'a, that when they come back and they respect the resolution that they themselves signed off on, they themselves agreed to in public, that that is in fact what is better for them. And this resolution was not revelation, right? This resolution or this agreement that was made between Muslims was a shura between Muslims. It was done, all these parties together, they decided this is what we're going to do. But Allah says they return not to the resolution. He says, حَتَّى تَفِيئَ إِلَىٰ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ, until they return to the command of Allah. The command of Allah. Now, what is Allah's command here? Allah's command is that islah that the Muslims made among themselves. Now that became part of the command of Allah. So you have to come back to it. It's a religious obligation. حَتَّى تَفِيئَ إِلَىٰ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. SubhanAllah, look at the injunction. The institution in our deen to protect us from going into worse and worse scenarios of infighting. And then look at the final words really get you. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَإِنْ فَأَتْ, if in fact, you know, they violated the treaty and everybody got on their case and they said, okay, fine, we're coming back to the treaty. We're coming back and respecting the original resolution. Once they've rebelled, everybody's got a bad taste in their mouth. And they're thinking, these people can't be trusted. Remember what they did 2 months ago? Remember what they did last year? They started fitna last. Now they're saying they're okay, but we know they're not really okay. So when you don't trust someone, and when you say they're not worthy of your trust, what you are saying in between the lines is they are not true believers, right? And how did the ayat begin, the conflict? What do you have to assume on both sides? True belief. Iman. So they say we're coming back, and we're going to respect the resolutions that were made, the reconciliation that was passed. You have to give them benefit of the doubt. فَإِنْ فَاءَتْ فَأَصْلِحُوا. Then if they come back, then make reconciliation. Don't say, no, you can't be trusted. We can't take your word anymore. This happens, this is real life. When people like that come back, you say, how can we trust them? They have a bad track record. Allah is speaking about a people who have a bad track record. فَإِنْ بَغَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَ عَلَى الْأُخْرَى. The bad track record has already been mentioned. Despite that, you give them benefit of the doubt. But then you make sure of one more thing. See, Allah doesn't want us to fall into this gullible situation where we say everybody's brothers, let's just trust one another. Because the Muslim, he doesn't trip by the same, you know, fall into the same snake hole twice. Right? The Muslim is wiser than that. And the ahkam of Allah have wisdom more than that. So when Allah calls us to make reconciliation again, He adds some words. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا بِالْعَدْلِ وَأَقْسِطُوا. Then make reconciliation between them with two things. He says, make reconciliation between them, reconcile between them with adl. Adl. Have you heard this word adl before? It means justice. And then he says, wa aqsitu, comes from the word qist. You know what qist means in English? It also means justice. He says, fa aqsitu, fa aslihu baynahuma bil adl wa aqsitu. He doesn't say, fa aslihu baynahuma bil adl wa adilu. Or he doesn't say, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا بِالْقِسْطِ وَأَقْسِطُوا. He uses two different words. He uses adl once and qist the other time. It's very important to understand this. In English, you read the translation and it says, reconcile between them with justice and be fair. And be fair. Now, when you think of justice in English or think of being fair in English, it's the same thing, right? to be fair and to be just. I want justice, I want fairness. It's the same thing. So Allah is not saying exactly the same thing. He's not using a synonym. He used adl one time and qist the other time. And if you understand the difference, subhanallah, how Allah protects this ummah from fitna. Adl, adl. Allah says when you make reconciliation between them, make sure there is adl. Adl means that you do justice, but you do justice publicly. There's a very big difference. You know, if there's a trial, there's a fair trial, there's a qualified judge, there's proper evidence, there's good lawyers on both sides, all of this stuff, right? But the trial is secret. No cameras, no jury, nobody. Closed doors. And the judge comes out and says, I've passed my decision and it's a fair trial. Are the people going to believe him? No. Because the people demand something. They demand, how did you make this decision? How come we didn't see the trial? The more secret a trial is, the more people are convinced what is involved, corruption is involved. And the more open a trial is, the more people are satisfied that there is justice. So when this meeting happens between two Muslim groups that are fighting, when you want to reconcile between them, after one has violated already, it's not a closed door meeting anymore. The first time, even there's room for closed door meeting because you don't want the propaganda to spread or bad news to spread in the Muslim community, bad name to spread. But if the situation has escalated, now we're in the second stage of the problem, then you have to make it a public display where everybody knows these are the evidences, this is what happened, so all the parties are satisfied. Do you see the evidence? Do you have anything to say against it? What's your proof against it? Make your case. So the case is done publicly. Why is this important? Because once this is done, when they go back, can they say to anybody, well, that wasn't a fair trial? Because everybody was there. They'll say, what do you mean it's not a fair trial? It's on YouTube. I saw the whole thing. It's open. Bil-adl. But then Allah Azza wa Jal says to the ummah at large, when you make reconciliation between Muslims, you use adl in this worst case scenario. And then finally, for all Muslims, use qist. And this is personal advice. The first part was advice to the community that wants to reconcile. The second part of the ayah, وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. This is for each one of us individually. Because qist is different from adl. Adl is public justice. Qist is justice whether you're in public or in private. You have to be fair at work, whether your boss is watching you or not. You have to be fair on the road. Small things like that, on the road. Somebody has right of way and you go in the service road and you cut them off. You've been unjust. Small. We don't think about these things, right? Because we don't think our deen applies on the road. It applies in the masjid. You're not giving, you promised your wife something. Or your children, you're not giving it to them. You're not being fair. You made an agreement with a brother, you're going to pay him back and you don't call him back and you send his calls to voicemail. Right? You're not being fair. So Allah says, whether public or private, we have to be fair. And the word for that is qist. وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Without a doubt, Allah loves the muqsitin. And then He says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. This is the ayah we're going to end with, inshaAllah ta'ala. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. And إِنَّمَا is a difficult word to translate in English. I like to use the terms, believers are nothing more than brothers to one another. All they amount to with each other is brothers. Now Allah didn't say, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَىٰ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمْ. Believers are brothers, so make peace between them. Allah didn't say that. Allah said, true believers, all they are to each other is brothers. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Reconcile between your brothers. You know, even the younger kids here, you know the difference between second person and third person? Third person is when you're talking about someone. Second person is when you're talking to someone. When I say he or she, what person is that? I know it's English class, but still. That's third person. When I say you, who is that? Second person. The ayah begins in third person. Believers are brothers. That's all they are. Believers are brothers. This is third person. But then Allah says, make peace between your brothers. What person is that? Second person. There's a big change from the beginning of the ayah to the middle of the ayah. How so? Because you know in this surah, beforehand, Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانِ. Allah has made iman beloved to you. Iman, Allah has put a love of iman in all of you. You want to be mu'minun, right? all Muslims, they don't want to be just Muslim. They want to be what? Mu'min. Now Allah is giving us in this ayah a chance to be mu'min. Because what does He say? Believers are what? True. Mu'minun are brothers. You want to be among the brothers, and the brothers are already called mu'minun. Make peace between your brothers. If you are their brothers, what does that make you? Mu'minun. If you make peace between them, you are guaranteed what? Iman. So Allah is giving us this beautiful tip on earning Iman. You want to make sure you're on the side of Iman? You're the one making the peace. You're the one pushing that we need to reconcile. We can't have fighting anymore. We need to bring people together. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ And then finally, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ Very profound words in which Allah Azza wa Jal ends this ayah. He says, have taqwa of Allah. Have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. Beware of Allah. Be conscious of Allah. Realize Allah's presence. Be in awe of it. Especially when you are making peace talks. Why? Because when the Muslims are talking to each other about a problem, especially about a problem, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَكُمْ Tell my slaves when they talk, speak in the best possible fashion, because without a doubt, Shaitan, he is going to cause friction between you, dissension between you. So when the Muslim speaks to the other Muslim, Shaitan comes and makes you hear something that he didn't say. You know, there's a way in, you know, I can give you a simple example. You know, you ever use instant messaging? You're instant messaging someone and they totally understand something different from what you were saying. They took it a whole other way. And you're like, I didn't mean that at all. And they say, but you used all caps. And it was blinking. So you were yelling at me. Right? So there's, you know, when we communicate with each other, it's a good possibility that when you say something, it's taken the wrong way. Shaitan ensures that when Muslims are trying to make peace between each other, he comes to one side and says, you know what he really meant when he said that? He meant this. I know he didn't say it, but he meant it. I know it. This happens between husband and wife all the time. Right? How was your day? She says. Oh, so you're saying I didn't do any work? You know? This sort of thing. She didn't say that. She said, how was your day? But you're reading it a whole other way. Right? Busy day at work? Oh, you're being sarcastic again? You know, this sort of thing. So what Shaitan does, he causes this friction between brothers. Now who is going to be able to catch on that this is the work of Shaitan? People that have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. So he says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ Have taqwa of Allah so you can be shown mercy. Look at this incredible advice of Allah Azza wa Jal. If these simple steps were implemented, the biggest problems are not problems anymore. You know, and subhanAllah, in the traditional Muslim societies, you will find murder cases. Murder cases. People come together, they read these ayat together, they reconcile, they make peace, and the justice is passed, and everybody's happy. People can resolve these things in the middle of villages, where they don't know the English alphabet, and they don't know the first thing about computers, and they can apply these ayat and execute justice. And we're living in the modern world. Educated people with high credentials, PhDs, doctorate, professionals, specialized in their fields, and they have fights, and they're fighting like children, and they can't sit down and listen to two ayat of Qur'an before they make peace between each other. Look at the tragedy of our times. Who we call uneducated have much better education than we do. And we're supposed to be the intellectuals of society, right? People that know what they're doing, people that have credentials and knowledge, and look how immorally and how ignorantly we behave. So I pray that Allah Azza wa Jal make us take these ayat as guidance and make them a means of reconciliation between any conflict that may have existed between the brothers. I'll finally end with this piece of advice, which we're going to talk about tomorrow inshallah. There are two principles in Islam, two principles that are very praised. There's justice and there's forgiveness. Justice and forgiveness. And you know, justice, the principle of justice in Islam is for everybody else. For mankind. Between the Muslims, what does Allah promote more? He promotes forgiveness. He promotes mercy. And you will look in the history of Islam, the first time Muslims had a major conflict, is when they were going after justice. Before that, they had a tradition of going for what? Forgiveness. So we'll talk about this fine line between justice and forgiveness. Allah says they're both good. So how do you decide between justice and forgiveness? Inshallah ta'ala, we'll have dust on that tomorrow. Barakallahu li wa lakum, shukran al-hakim, wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum, bil ayat wa dhikr al-hakim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.